tonight, it's our most confident contestant ever.
I'm truthful, I tell it how it is, I'm gonna tell you how it is.
But will government employee Anthony Sciano be as cocky when the questions get personal?
Have you ever told someone classified information that you knew you should not reveal? Have you ever seen a family member commit a crime and not reported it? Have you considered that your birth defect could be a result of your mother not taking better care of herself while she was pregnant?
I love mom.
I know you do.
I love her.
And a painful family secret drives him to his emotional breaking point.
Have you ever wished you had a different father?
Oh, God, I'm gonna stop crying.
Tonight, the only thing that separates a person from $500,000 is 21 questions and their ability to answer each one of these questions with the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Is there an honest person left in America? The time has come to face the moment of truth. Prior to tonight's show, all of our participants have undergone a rigorous polygraph exam. They don't know the results of that test, but if they tell the truth, they can win up to $500,000. And if for any reason they feel they may not have been truthful during the polygraph test, they can change their answers tonight. Let's meet our first participant.
Anthony Sciano is a 30-year-old cost engineer from Brooklyn, New York. He is the youngest of three children. He was asked over 50 questions by a polygraph examiner. 21 have been chosen for tonight.
Anthony Sciano, this is your moment of truth. Welcome to the show, Anthony.
How's everything, man?
Really good. Glad to have you here.
Glad to be here.
Have a seat.
Thank you.
Normally, I would ask if you're a little nervous, but with that entrance, I don't think you have any nerves at all.
I'm ready to go, man. I'm ready, man. I'm truthful. I tell it how it is. I'm gonna tell you how it is. You look good today. Good job. They dressed well, and let's go.
All right. You think you're gonna be able to tell the truth in front of all of America tonight?
That's what I plan on doing.
Fantastic. Anthony, there are six levels of questioning. The further you go, the harder the questions get. Don't forget that. But the more money you can earn on your way to $500,000. You can quit at any time, take the money, but once you hear a question, you have to answer that question. And remember, if you're caught lying even one time, you lose everything and the game is over. Okay?
Yeah.
You're not only telling the truth in front of all of America tonight, Anthony, you brought family and friends with you. Let's meet them right now.
Hi, I'm Maria, and I'm Anthony's sister.
I'm Robert, I'm Anthony's cousin.
Hi, I'm Ricardo. I'm Anthony's best friend.
Glad to have you.
Thank you.
You realize that we're going to ask some very personal questions tonight.
That's all right.
You understand and you're ready?
Yep.
I'm ready.
Anthony, are you ready?
Yes.
I'm ready as I'm ever going
to
be.
Then let's get to it.
Come on, baby.
Ready, baby.
Let's go.
Anthony, level one has six questions. It's the most questions you'll ever have to answer to get money on the show. It gets easier every time. Although the questions get harder. Answer all six of these level one questions truthfully and you win $10,000. Now, yes, remember, if you're ever concerned about the answers you gave on your polygraph exam, you can change them tonight.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
You're locked and loaded and ready to go.
Locked and loaded, ready to go.
What do you do for a living?
I am a cost engineer for the government.
Government worker?
Yeah. So I estimate how much it costs to do this, that, and the other thing.
This, that, and the other thing.
Yes. It's very technical like that, too.
Yeah,
you got the this, you got the that, and then
of course
you got
the other thing.
Yes.
I hope you go a long way. I don't want you to leave too soon.
No.
Yeah.
Now he just jinxed me. Can I get another host, please?
Question one.
Let's go.
While working at your government job, have you ever looked at pornographic material on the internet? Anthony, we talked about this and that. I think that's the other thing. Robert, what do you think his answer will be?
I think it's gonna be a no, yeah.
No way.
Maria?
Absolutely yes.
It's gotta be a no.
Gotta be a no.
He knows the rules.
All right, that's what family and friends think, but all that really matters, Anthony, is what is true for you. So answer this question. While working at your government job, have you ever looked at pornographic material on the internet?
Yes, I have.
I wouldn't have thought that.
The sister always knows.
That answer is true.
One truthful answer. Five more, $10,000. Your sister knows you very well.
She does. She does.
Maria, how did you know that?
How did you know that?
Because you sent it to me. All right, she's a big sister. She looks out for her little brother.
That's right.
Do you come from a big family?
Yes. As far as cousins and stuff like that, my father was one of 16, so.
Oh, my.
Yeah, they had no TV in Italy, so it was constantly,
right.
You know.
Yeah.
Because of my immediate family, it's me, my two sisters, and my mom, Dukes.
Question two.
Awesome.
Do you think you're the smartest person in your family? Maria, how do you feel about this?
I think my brother is the smartest person in the family. So,
it's
okay.
You wouldn't be surprised if he were to say
that. Not at all. He's done very well for himself.
So? Wow. Anthony, do you think you're the smartest person in your family?
Mark, I am a genius. There's a genius and then there's me. Honestly. Honestly.
So your answer is?
My answer is no, I'm not.
That answer is true.
Two truthful answers, four more, $10,000. Who do you think is the smartest person?
Yeah.
Well, to be honest, I mean, all right, I have an engineering degree, so you're supposed to be smart. I guess I am somewhat. But even though you're lazy at times, you are one smart son of a gun. You know, I mean,
thank you.
She's my sister, man. She's a small cookie. I love you, baby.
Thank you.
I love you.
Nice to hear that, isn't it?
Yeah.
He's a good guy.
He's a great guy.
You know it's true. I mean, honestly, come on.
What makes you feel good?
Everything. I'm happy to be alive. I love my friends, my family. I just have a good time. You know, I've been through a lot of crap in life. It's too easy to be down. Just enjoy yourself.
Enjoy yourself.
I'm on the moment of truth right now. I mean, honestly, I mean, how many people get a chance like this?
Right, so you should enjoy yourself no matter what people think.
No matter what. Even if I lose tonight, I'm still gonna enjoy myself.
Question three.
Oh, great. Can we stop here? No, go ahead.
As an adult, have you ever worn women's clothing? Cousin Robert, what do you think the answer is to this?
Well, you've got to know him for a little while now, and so I'm gonna have to say yes.
What?
Ricardo?
I'm hoping he says no. Yeah.
Thank you.
You better say no.
Thank you.
Maria?
I'm gonna go with yes again.
Can I get some more family members? Anybody wanna, you know? We can pretend here, it's okay. I don't know these people, honestly.
As an adult, have you ever worn women's clothing?
Yes.
I can't believe it.
That answer is true.
That's three, halfway to $10,000. You want to explain that one at all?
Of course I joke around with my girlfriend here and there, but honestly, who hasn't dressed up like a woman? Everybody thinks it's funny, you know. I'm gonna be a woman. You're on national TV. Don't look so funny now.
Listen, all I want to do is give you a bunch of money.
I want to take.
I want to help you get there, and I want you guys to be aware of how you can help as well. That's three questions. We're in round one. We're having a great time. I think everybody here would love to see this guy go all the way to $500,000.
Yeah.
Thank you.
The questions, at some point, are bound to turn very personal. And you, as family and friends, have come here not only to support Anthony, but to help him win money and possibly protect yourself in the process. There's a button right there. You know about that button. At any time, if there's a question you don't want to hear the answer to, hit the button. I'll replace the question. You can only use it one time, though, okay?
Okay.
All right. Three questions on our way to $10,000. Must be nice having not only your sister and your cousin here, but your friend Ricardo here as well.
Better believe it. It's my buddy. We sure had some good times together.
Question four.
Let me hear it.
Have you ever been physically attracted to another man? Ricardo.
It better be a no. I've shared a bed with him. It better be a no.
Awesome. No, I haven't.
That answer is... true.
I could tell a guy, you know, I could say if this guy's good looking or bad looking, I'm fine with that. I'm secure in my manhood, you know.
Right.
I love the ladies. But no, I mean, unfortunately, you know, no offense to other men that want me to feel physically attracted to them. I'm not. I mean, I'm going to tell you.
Hey, the good news is you were truthful, and that's four truthful answers.
That's right. Get closer and closer. Closer and closer.
You know we can stop at any time, but we haven't earned any money yet. You want to keep going?
What do you want to do?
Going,
of course.
That's what we're here for.
That's it.
Thanks. Here comes question five. If you knew a coworker was stealing from the company, would you turn that person in? That's a tough question, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not an easy one, you know? Especially, like they say, you're Italian or you're a rat, you know?
Yeah. But with all the jokes and stuff, I can tell you take your work seriously.
Yeah, I do. I do. You know, I get paid to do a job, and, you know, when there is things that are confidential, or, you know, especially the way the world is, unfortunately, now. So, would I? Yes, I would turn that person.
That answer is true.
Look at that. Five truthful answers, only one more, $10,000. You obviously take your work pretty seriously.
Yes, I do. It's weird to admit that, but yes, I do.
You have a government job. What kind of clearance do you have?
It depends on the job. I mean, you know, nothing top secret, so they're aliens. I wish I could tell you. But
there is a security clearance sort of criteria.
Yes, depending on the project, yes, there is.
Okay. For $10,000, question six. Have you ever told someone classified information that you knew you should not reveal?
Coming up, Anthony Sciano confronts the truth about his painful childhood.
Do you blame your mother for your birth defect?
And his strained relationship with his father forces him to deal with emotions he's kept bottled up for years.
Have you ever wished you had a different father? If your father called you in the middle of the night from jail, would you bail him out?
This is the one I was worried about.
Me too.
Moment of truth continues.
Five truthful answers, only one more, $10,000. You obviously take your work pretty seriously.
Yes, I do. It's weird to admit that, but yes, I do.
You have a government job. What kind of clearance do you have?
It depends on the job. I mean, you know, nothing top secret, so they're aliens. I wish I could tell you. But
there is a security clearance sort of criteria.
Yes, depending on the project, yes, there is.
Okay. For $10,000, question six. Have you ever told someone classified information that you knew you should not reveal? For $10,000, yes or no?
Yes, I have.
That answer is true.
Congratulations, you just won $10,000.
Thanks.
Not bad, huh? $10,000, you did a great job to get there, but you know, that answer obviously weighed heavily on your mind. You got very serious when I asked you this question. You wanna tell me about this?
Classified information, you know, is what you get briefed on at the job. There are things that are classified. But I was working on a project, and I was only briefed on it, and I needed help with an estimate, and I asked one of my coworkers. And he said, well, what project is that? Unfortunately, I said the name of the project, so I'm not gonna lie and say, no, I have it. Unfortunately, I have.
Well, I appreciate your explanation, and congratulations on the $10,000. So, $10,000 for just a few minutes' work, not bad.
Not bad at all.
It's your money if you want to take off right now, take the family out, have a cocktail, have some dinner, and say, wow, that was pretty easy.
Guys?
No, not yet.
We need a lot. $10,000 is not going to cover it.
$10,000 is not going to cover it, huh? What do you want to do?
We're going to go.
All right. Level two now. Five questions. $25,000. Let's get you there. Level two, definitely going to be more personal. Going to go into your family life.
Saw that coming. I'm ready.
Okay. Good. Button's still there if you need it.
We ready? We all right?
We're all right.
All right.
You guys love me no matter what, right?
It's all about you.
Oh, great. Thanks.
Your mother's not on the couch. Why didn't she come to the show tonight?
She's old school. I love my mom to death, you know, and this is, it's just not her gig, you know? My mom is more reserved, and I can't blame her for it. Not everybody, you know, wants their stuff out there.
But you, you respect your mom quite a bit, it sounds
like. I love my mom to death. My mom, Dukes, is one of a kind.
Question seven. Have you ever broken up with a girlfriend because your mother did not like her?
I do love my mom to death. You know, I respect what she says. I mean, she's put us through a lot, you know, and she's helped us out a lot and guided us in the right way. And I listen to a good percentage of stuff she'll tell me. But, no. I've never broke up with a woman because my mother told me.
That answer is true.
As promised, we're gonna get a little bit more serious, and we've touched on your childhood, but what was your childhood like for you?
I was born with a birth defect. It's called a cleft lip and cleft palate. I came out, you know, I wasn't put together. I wasn't a full baby at that point. I had doctors from 10 days old repair my lip, from a year old repair my palate, had braces on, had my jaw broken, four titanium plates, two here and two here. And, you know, I had doctors donate their time. And, you know, not a lot of people just do that just because, you know, for what? You know, why do I gotta help you out for? I can't thank enough people between my mother supporting me through everything. I mean, I know she's not here today, and, you know, I just want to tell you I love you, Ma. Thank you.
Well, I'm glad to see you now as a handsome, strong guy who's grateful for everything.
Thank you.
Question eight. Could you ever date a girl with a cleft lip?
It's a good question. And it's a fair question. Honestly, this is?
Yeah.
No, I couldn't.
That answer is true.
There's a reason for that. There's a reason for that. There's more of a risk. If he had children, you know, there's a more of a probability that he could have children like this. And knowing what he's gone through, you have to live it in order to know it. So I understand that.
I love you.
I love you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Courage, honesty has you through 8 questions on your way to $25,000. If you are someone who was born with this, I'm sure as a young child, it's hard to get that around your head. Why me? Why did this happen? Why me? Question 9. Have you considered that your birth defect could be a result of your mother not taking better care of herself while she was pregnant?
Coming up, the questions get more serious, and Anthony Sciano is pushed to his breaking point.
Would you still have children if you knew they would be born with the same birth defect you have?
And his painful relationship with his father forces him to deal with emotions he's kept secret for years.
Have you ever wished you had a different father? If your father called you in the middle of the night from jail, would you bail him out?
This is the one I was worried about.
Me too.
Get that, but the more money you can earn on your way to $500,000, you can quit at any time, take the money, but once you hear a question, you have to answer that question. And remember, if you're caught lying even one time, you lose everything and the game is over. Okay?
Yeah.
You're not only telling the truth in front of all of America tonight, Anthony, you brought family and friends with you. Let's meet them right now.
Hi, I'm Maria, and I'm Anthony's sister.
I'm Robert, I'm Anthony's cousin.
Hi, I'm Ricardo, I'm Anthony's best friend.
Glad to have you.
Thank you.
You realize that we're going to ask some very personal questions tonight.
That's all right.
That's all right.
You understand and you're ready?
Yep.
I'm ready.
Anthony, are you ready?
Yes.
I'm ready as I'm ever going to be.
Then let's get to it. Anthony, level 1 has 6 questions. It's the most questions you'll ever have to answer to get money on the show. It gets easier every time, although the questions get harder. Answer all 6 of these level 1 questions truthfully and you win $10,000. Now, yes, remember, if you're ever concerned about the answers you gave on your polygraph exam, you can change them tonight.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
You're locked and loaded and ready to go.
Locked and loaded, ready to go.
What do you do for a living?
I am a cost engineer for the government.
Government worker?
Yeah. So okay. I estimate how much it costs to do this, that, and the other thing.
This, that, and the other thing?
Yes. It's very technical like that, too.
Yeah,
you got the this, you got the that.
Prior to tonight's show, all of our participants have undergone a rigorous polygraph exam. They don't know the results of that test, but if they tell the truth, they can win up to $500,000. And if for any reason they feel they may not have been truthful during the polygraph test, they can change their answers tonight. Let's meet our first participant.
Anthony Sciano is a 30-year-old cost engineer from Brooklyn, New York. He is the youngest of 3 children. He was asked over 50 questions by a polygraph examiner. 21 have been chosen for tonight.
Anthony Sciano, this is your moment of truth. Welcome to the show, Anthony.
How's everything, man?
Really good. Glad to have you here.
Glad to be here.
Have a seat.
Thank you.
Normally, I would ask if you're a little nervous, but with that entrance, I don't think you have any nerves at all.
I'm ready to go, man. I'm ready, man. I'm truthful. I tell it how it is. I'm going to tell you how it is. You look good today. Good job. They dressed well, and let's go.
All right. You think you're going to be able to tell the truth in front of all of America tonight?
That's what I plan on doing.
Fantastic. Anthony, there are 6 levels of questioning. The further you go, the harder the questions get. Don't forget.
And then
of course, there's the other thing.
Yes.
I hope you go a long way. I don't want you to leave too soon.
No.
Yeah.
Right, now he just jinxed me. Can I get another host, please?
Question 1.
Let's go.
While working at your government job, have you ever looked at pornographic material on the internet? Anthony, we talked about this and that. I think that's the other thing. Robert, what do you think his answer will be?
I think it's going to be a no. Yeah.
No way.
Maria?
Absolutely yes.
It's got to be a no.
Got to be a no.
He knows the rules.
All right, that's what family and friends think, but all that really matters, Anthony, is what is true for you. So answer this question. While working at your government job, have you ever looked at pornographic material on the internet?
Yes, I have.
I wouldn't have thought that.
The sister always knows.
That answer is true.
One truthful answer. Five more, $10,000. Your sister knows you very well.
She does. She does.
Maria, how did you know that?
Because...
How did you know that? Because you sent it to me.
Tonight, it's our most confident contestant ever.
I'm truthful. I tell it how it is. I'm going to tell you how it is.
But will government employee Anthony Sciano be as cocky when the questions get personal?
Have you ever told someone classified information that you knew you should not reveal? Have you ever seen a family member commit a crime and not reported it? Have you considered that your birth defect could be a result of your mother not taking better care of herself while she was pregnant?
I love mom.
I know you do.
I love her.
And a painful family secret drives him to his emotional breaking point.
Have you ever wished you had a different father?
Oh, God, I want to stop crying.
Tonight, the only thing that separates a person from $500,000 is 21 questions and their ability to answer each one of these questions with the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Is there an honest person left in America? The time has come to face the moment of truth.
All right, you're a big sister. She looks out for her little brother.
That's right.
Do you come from a big family?
Yes. As far as cousins and stuff like that, my father was one of 16, so.
Oh, my.
Yeah, they had no TV in Italy, so it was constantly,
right.
You know.
Yeah.
Because of my immediate family, it's me, my two sisters, and my mom, Dukes.
Question two.
Awesome.
Do you think you're the smartest person in your family? Maria, how do you feel about this?
I think my brother is the smartest person in the family. So,
it's
okay.
You wouldn't be surprised if he were to say
it. Not at all. Not at all. He's done very well for himself.
So? Wow. Anthony, do you think you're the smartest person in your family?
Mark, I am a genius. There's a genius and then there's me. Honestly. Honestly.
So your answer is?
My answer is no, I'm not.
That answer is true.
Two truthful answers, four more, $10,000. Who do you think is the smartest person?
Yeah.
Well, to be honest, I mean, all right, I have an engineering degree, so you're supposed to be smart. I guess I am.